Hello children, welcome to the biology class. So previous class we discussed about the nerves. So three types of nerves, how the nerve cell will be. Now we are going to discuss about the major divisions of the brain. That is nervous system. What are the two major divisions of nervous system? That is central nervous system and peripheral nervous system. So central nervous system includes the brain and spinal cord combined with it the vertebral column. That is so important that it is entirely protected by bone. That is what? Skull, brain, spinal cord contained within the vertebral column. Next, peripheral nervous system. That is PNS. Central nervous system, CNS, peripheral nervous system, short form PNS. So it includes the nerves that emerge from and enter into the brain and spinal cord. So it includes the nerves, all other nerves. See, autonomic nervous system, that is fight or flight response, resting and digesting response. So the PNS consists of two subdivisions, that is peripheral nervous system, that is somatic nervous system and autonomous nervous system. So somatic nervous system conveys the information to skeletal muscles, that is voluntary muscles, and autonomic nervous system includes a pair of chains of ganglia and nerves which control the involuntary action of many internal organs like muscles, heart muscles and secretion from the glands that are by automatics that are controlled. So automatic nervous system which controls the involuntary action of internal organs, that is autonomic nervous system. Next, in that central nervous system, first we are going to discuss about the brain. See here, central nervous system, brain and spinal cord. So which are integrative and control centers. Next, peripheral nervous system contains cranial nerves and spinal nerves. So communication lines between the central nervous system and the rest of the body. So cranial nerves which arises from the spinal cord, spinal nerves from the spinal cord and cranial nerves from the brain that passes through whole body. Next, that passes to motor, that is efferent division, that motor nerve fibers and conducts the impulse from the central nervous system to the effectors. What are the effectors? Muscles and glands. So from here they will pass to the autonomic nervous system. Autonomic nervous system which controls the involuntary actions, that is conduct impulse from the central nervous system to the cardiac muscles, mouth muscles and the glands. And somatic nervous system which acts on the voluntary muscles, conduct impulse from the central nervous system to the skeletal nervous system. From here they passes to the sympathetic nervous system, that is mobilizes the body system during the emergency situations. Mobilizes means which initiates, which moves the body. And parasympathetic means conserves the energy and promotes non-emergency functions, that is ideas. So sensory afferent division, that is somatic and visceral sensory nerve fibers, conduct impulse receptors to the central nervous system. Again they pass to the peripheral nervous system, again to the central nervous system. So the reasons of brain. So the brain, in the proportion of to the size of the body, the human brain is the largest among all the animals. In all the animals, the brain is the biggest part, we can say. That means according to the body size, in proportion to the size of the body, the human brain is the largest. So the brain is very delicate organ and it is well protected by the skull. So it is well protected inside by brain box or cranium of the skull. So the adult brain weighs about 1.35 kgs and constitute about 2% of the body's total weight. So it contains almost 80%, that is, it is 80% of water and consumes more than 25% of total oxygen taken into the body. So whatever the oxygen you inhale, in that brain utilizes 25%, and it consumes 80% of water. So coverings, that is meninges. So meninges are three types coverings of the brain. The brain is protected by three membranes. The brain is protected by three membranes, coverings called meninges. Meninges means what? Membranes. So the membranes are called meninges, which constitute backward to the spinal cord. We have dura mater, arachnoid and pia mater. What is dura mater? Dura mater means that is the outermost tough fibrous membrane. So the tough matter is called dura mater, that is the outermost matter, outermost membrane. Next is arachnoid. What is arachnoid? The thin delicate middle layer giving web like cushion. So arachnoids are what? Spiders. If you take the arthropoda classification, arachnoids are what? Arachnoids are spiders. See, you can see here. First is diameter, which is a tough region. Next is arachnoid, which are web-like structures. A middle layer resembles like a fine web-like cushion, or we can say cobweb, spider-like. Next is pia mater, which is the innermost highly vascular membrane and richly supplied with blood. So that is called pia mater. These are the three coverings of the brain. And brain is divided into three regions, that is cerebrum, diencephalon, brainstem and cerebellum. See here, adult brain consists of cerebral hemisphere, that is called cerebrum. Next, diencephalon, cerebellum and main brain stem. These are the regions of the brain. So meningitis or meningitis is the inflammation of the meninges. If the inflammation, any infection to this meninges called meningitis. The space between the covering membrane is filled with watery fluid called cerebrospinal fluid. Children, what is the fluid present in the brain? Is cerebrospinal fluid. So which is present between the covering membranes, which acts like a cushion to protect the brain from shocks. So the same fluid also flows and fills the central spaces of the brain and the central canal of the spinal cord. So in the next class, children, we'll discuss about the parts of the brain, that is what? Cerebrum, cerebellum and medulla oblongata. Okay, children, till then have a good day.